What is up, DTube, Steam Blockchain? So today I want to talk a little bit about the Bitcoin halvening. What's going on? So it's supposed to happen, I think, around May the 12th, which is, I think, in around 77 days. It may be 75 days, to be honest. Probably more like that. So, if you go look at 2016 halvening, when I looked at the charts, it almost seems like before the halvening, it sort of went up in price. Well, if you look at the price action, the last, I don't know, one or two months, yeah, it went up, but then it went down, kind of. And if you look at, so for example, it reached a high of 10,400, and then it went down to like, now like 8,500. That seems to be a pretty big dump. I mean, what is that? 1,500? That's like $2,000 almost gone. In a very short time, to be honest. And it's like, you look at this and people say like, maybe it's not going to be exactly like 2016, but it's like, okay, so Bitcoin has been here for 10 years and it still has this huge, massive volatility. I don't know, man. It's like, in terms of opportunity, it seems like newer coins are going to give more opportunity with real markets and real use cases. Go back to 2017 high, 20,000. Where is that right now? 8,500. And what is this? Like 3 years later? And we're like 10 months away from 2021. And we still, what is it now? Like 60% down since 2017. That's many, many years. That's many, many years of like nothing happening. Nothing interesting at all happening. Well, there's a bunch of other cool things that's happening. So rare. ETH, football card games, collectibles. Night Story doing stuff with Ethereum and collectibles. EOS Dynasty doing stuff on EOS smart contracts. I mean, there's just Steam launching communities. Avalon Chain coming this summer. It seems like other projects have more opportunity and that they're doing stuff faster. And you also have Ethereum working on privacy, smart contracts that may come later, 2020. It's just a lot of stuff going on with these other things that looks kind of fascinating, like more engaging, more fun. So what is going on with the Bitcoin halvening? It's going to be interesting to see what's going to happen. Like, is it really going to pump? I don't know, man. It's like there was a lot of these like financial institutions that was supposed to buy Bitcoin, and people talked about that a lot in 2018, 2019. But there was only like a scam project called Plus Token that kind of pumped it in 2019, and it's like the scammers pumped Bitcoin, not like the financial institutions that much. So it's like, is it really gonna pump that much? And there's been a bunch of talking about stock to flow and all this. And I looked at those charts and they said that, well, in 2019, they said, oh, look at the charts here. It looks like 2020, we're going to go to 55,000, you know, 55. And now it seems like they sort of, when they look at the charts now, it seems like now they're just starting to talk about 2021, like, yeah, we're going to 100K in 2021, but forget about the 50,000 thing. Forget about it. And I don't know, I mean, maybe it can like pump 10x, 20x or something like that, but, and maybe it's going to happen 2022, 2023, who knows, maybe even 2021, maybe even this year. But you look at the track record and it's like, I don't know, man. It's like, we have like some coins that are doing almost like a 10x in a month. And Bitcoin reached $1,000 late 2013. It reached $1,000. And now we are, what is it, like 7 years later, and it's only an 8x from then. So if you bought at that time and just held up to this day, you would only have made an 8x. An 8x in crypto in like 7 years, it doesn't really sound that fun. Some other coins have done 10,000x. Ethereum did that in 2.5 years. Binance coin did like 430x. I don't know, like even EOS and like Steam, these have made like 30x also in like shorter time frames. So it's like, what's gonna happen? I don't know. But it seems like something is gonna happen. Either that you get a mad pump or a mad dump. Like, I would be fascinated to see how the crypto industry would react if Bitcoin went down to like 3k or 2k or 1k. That would be interesting to see how they would like respond to that and how they would sort of look at the industry. And if some people really, maybe they would like do 100% capitulate. I don't really know. But it would be fascinating to see. It would also be fascinating to see if we saw like a mad pump, because what I think what would happen with a mad pump is I think that would pump altcoins even harder. So if Bitcoin would go like 10x, I think some altcoins would probably go 100x or like 300x. Because it seems like people are unloading a lot of those profits into alts. So it's kind of like interesting to sort of see how these interact with each other. So yeah, we're only like 2 months away. What is it, like to March, April, May? Yeah, around 2 months away, maybe 2.5 months away. It's gonna be interesting because it seems like something's gonna happen, either up massively or dump massively. It doesn't seem like it's gonna remain at the same level, but we have to see.